If you've been to the Vietnam Wall Memorial, you know each name tells a unique story.
And the one we're about to tell you has a surprising twist. Chief Warrant Officer Donald Wann will finally have a proper burial next week, decades after he disappeared during his second tour in the Vietnam War. But what's so unique about his story is the surprise came from a stranger that's finally helped a family find peace. At the airport, and Shannon Plaster's journey has brought her here, one flight closer to her dad.
It's overwhelming joy and happiness that I've never had, so I'm just really thrilled.
Her dad was Chief Warrant Officer Donald Wann, killed while serving our country 39 years ago. His Army helicopter shot down in the Vietnam War. His remains MIA, that is, until earlier this year.
Department of Defense has recovered my dad's remains from 1971, and then March 20th of 2010 is when I was notified that the ID was through DNA testing and through dental records.
Now she's headed to Hawaii to bring her dad home. But before she left, Shannon Plaster got another surprise. Just last week, a man from Maine tracked her down. Patrick Constance had something of her dad's he wanted to give her.
So he drove from Maine to Shawnee without knowing who he was going to find.
It was her father's POW bracelet, similar to the one Plaster had made herself. Mr. Constant had been wearing her dad's bracelet since 1980.
I was like, what? Are you kidding me? It was shocking. It was, and I told him the timing is like from God.
Plaster says it's been a long road, 19 years of research it took to find her dad's remains. A journey that has now brought her peace.
Search and seek people. That's what I've done to help me heal my heart and find all these guys that flew with my dad. I mean, it's just amazing how everything just come together.
And now she can literally bring him back home.
I tell people it's a miracle from God. It really is.
And say goodbye by honoring his sacrifice.
What an amazing story. A funeral service for Donald Wann will be held next Saturday in Muskogee. He'll then be buried at Fort Gibson with full military honors.